Yes, good morning, class. I am audible to you? Yes?
Yes, sir.
My screen is visible?
Yes, sir.
Keshav?
Yes, sir.
Are you there?
Yes, sir.
Yes, class. My voice is coming to you.
Yes, sir.
Right. So I will start from the previous lecture, right, where we ended, and I will talk about few things that need to be. We have to take care of that, right? As per our syllabus, right? So as per our syllabus, you have to understand many applications, right? What is client-server model, right? This is a 2 marks question that we have discussed in the previous class. Where in client-server model, we understood that RPC, what is remote procedure call, right? So there is always a request and reply, right? So there is a request for the service, where service server is responsible to provide the service. Please remember this thing, right? Server is responsible to provide some service, right? There is no server which will provide all the types of service. We have a dedicated server, means providing a dedicated service like SMTP. Then we having FTP, all these are there. Then we are having HTTP. These all are the, we have DNS. Then we having many more, network server also. DHCP, Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. So these all are the different protocols, and these protocols are providing some of the service. So similarly, we having a server for this one, DNS and network server. So in client server model, what we are getting, we are requesting for service. This service depend upon the type of server we are using. Getting type of server. Which type of server over here is, suppose we are using DHCP server, Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. So what is the role of DHCP? To provide IP address, right? So here the client, when boot up, suppose this model, again, client server model, where client is requesting for address. Since we know that any device in a network want to communicate, first thing that is needed is the address, right? So if that thing is not done manually, then we have to provide the address with some kind of server like this DHCP server, right? So DHCP server will check the pool of IP, right? From pool of IP, it will provide one address. You can see one address to this particular device, right? So in that pool of IP, here the network administrator, network admin, has set the IPs between, suppose, 10.0.0.1 to 10.0.0.50. Now suppose what it means, from 1 to 50, all these are the IPs which could be easily allotted to the device who will request for it, right? So here one client when boot up, coming to the network and trying to get the address. Otherwise, that device could not able to recognize in a network. As you know, the protocol is the minimum criteria. Otherwise, you have seen that error when we are trying it in a packet tracer. So what will happen when this request forwarded to the server? Server will receive that request and then check into the configuration file where all that configuration has been set, right? So here configuration has set to 10 to 50. So which one is available? It might happen that one is already allotted to someone, right? So server is maintaining some kind of table. Try to understand that thing. Table, and that 10.0.0.1 is allotted already, right? So it will be mentioned over there. So server will check in the pool of IP. That is what I am saying, pool of IP, right? So from the pool of IP, now it will check that anyone is available. So if anyone is available, suppose 1.20, last in the last octet, it is 20, suppose. So means that address is available. So what will what the server will do? Server will respond to this request, and server will extract the source address from where that request has arrived, right? Because when that request is made, two, three things has been added in that request. One is the source address. We call it SA. Then the destination address, DA, right? Then the type of packet for which the request has been made. Either the request is for availing the IP address, right? So here that information will be there. Now server will extract this source address from where the request has arrived. Along with that, it will associate its IP address from the pool of table, which is there with its configuration. So what it will do, it will now use this source address during the during the reply. This source address will become destination address. Try to understand this thing. Along with the IP address, which user has demanded. So this information will go back to this thing particular, right? So this was, we have understood in the previous class, I have told you about this thing. If you have any doubt, any type of doubt in this particular, you can ask me. Meanwhile, I'm going to take your attendance, and every one of you are requested to write your attendance by writing present in the chat box. And let me take your screenshot for this. Right. Yes. All of you, please mark your attendance by writing present. And if you have any doubt, you please clear it out right now in this particular. Now, this process which has happened is known as remote procedure call, right? Or you can say client server model, which we are using. Okay, coming back to the next slide. So what you will find over here, the advantage and disadvantage, which we have already discussed, so I'm not going to talk about that thing again. Yes. So these are the disadvantage in that single model, single server model, where what is happening, there is a you can see problem, issue, that servers are prone to denial of service attack, right? So one of the live example which I have discussed with you is the Yahoo attack, right? So you just check it out, yahoo.com. If you check it out, you will find it that distributed denial of service attack or DOS attack, case study for that. So you can simply find it out. That I have already discussed that particular, where a fake request has been made to the server. Now server will become busy to reply on that fake responses, Right. So I have told you about the security measurement where we are having this 3CIA, right? That is confidentiality, availability, and integrity, right? So we have to protect all these three measurements, right? Availability. Now, availability is associated with this, right? How it is associated? Now, I have told you that server is providing some kind of service means if for any request, it will respond, right? So there may happen that attacker may use fake messages, right? And make that server busy, right? Because it has some capacity. This server has some capacity. Now suppose 256 is the maximum, you can say connection at a time, if this server could able to made. And now, if a attacker has made some zombies or some devices which will attack to this particular server at the same time. Now suppose 1,000 devices they attacked to this server. Attack means they basically giving a request, right? They are giving a request that we want your service, right? In this manner. So server will not able to differentiate between the actual message or it is a fake message, right? So this is the problem with the server. Server will cannot able to distinguish the actual message or the fake message. Now what will happen, since server is busy in responding to all the fake messages, and when there is an actual message from your side, what will happen? You have to wait for how long, you never know, because server is busy in responding to all the messages to which that from the zombies devices or the attacker has done previously. So in that manner, what we are saying, that availability of that service is no more with you, right? So we are compromising with the security in this manner. So that's why it is said over here that server are prone to denial of service attacks, yeah, right? So that is the problem. I have already discussed this thing. If you have any doubt, you can ask me again. Yes, class. Okay. So moving further. So this is the model. This, you can see that remote procedure call, RPC. Right. So RPC is what? Where the client will use random port number. Please remember this thing. Remember port number for the request. And server will respond with the fixed reserved port number. As we know, from port number 1 to port number 1024, right? Please remember that port, how many ports we have in total? 2^16. That will be equivalent to how much? 65,535. This much number of ports or application that could be possible for that thing that we want to communicate in a server model, right? So, but in that category, what is done, the servers are reserved between these number, that is 1 to 1024, right? Then other are reserved, you have to pay for it, then you can have that port number for your particular application. And after that, from something around between above 60,000, you can see that these are used, they are left intentionally. They are not used because clients, they will going to use some port number and they will pick up randomly, right? In that manner. So we have to, like we have private IP and public IP. Similarly, we have this private port number. So these port number are left for some of the application so that they can able to utilize this port for the communication, right? So please remember, only reserved server could able to use this port number. They cannot go for private devices like client machine. They cannot go with this port numbers since it is reserved with the server, right? For understanding this thing, I'm explaining you. Otherwise, when that unit will come, I will explain you in detail that how it is happening, right? Since in unit 4, we will learn about this thing. that what is IP address and port number, and port, how ports are associated with the applications, in order to make it separate, in order to make them identified uniquely, right? So we have a list of that, you know, ports, right? And that are fixed, right? We cannot change them accordingly, right? So this was some of the application peer-to-peer where we have studied business to customer, customer to business, government and all. Even then we have studied that mobile users, where we could able to have a wireless and mobility together, right? So the last one we have discussed in the previous class. Moving further, the topic. And these are the devices. Now you can see they are also connected in a network. Previously, we cannot think of that your hand machine like watches, smart watches, right? And devices, these are already connected with 3G and 4G. Now we are waiting for 5G, which is much faster up to in Gbps. Now we are going to talk about the speed in Gbps. If you see closely from the generation 1 to generation 5, the difference since after generation 3, you can see from 1 to 3, drastic development. You can say in a manner that in first generation we only have voice communication, right? We don't have SMS type of service, we don't have multimedia service, we don't have internet in first generation, right? Then in second generation also we have SMS and all, but then there is no internet till then. But then there is a improvement and technology get evolved. Then we have 2.5. In that we got GPRS. So internet is introduced in 2.5G. That is 2.5 generation, not second generation, not third generation, in between at that. So GPRS was introduced. Then after that, we have edge technology is also there. You might have seen many times that E letter is written in your screen. That is your edge technology, much faster as compared to this one GPRS. Right. So it was, the speed was in kbps, right? Kbps. Then 3G was introduced, right? Then the speed has improved from kbps to much better than mbps, right? In 2G, in 3G and 4G, right? But other services are also included over here in 3G, you can see. And if you observe more closely, what you understand that the race is all about the data rate, right? There is a race between all the service provider, and they are working for what? They are working for high data rate, right? So there is a difference that you can see over here now, and to connect more and more devices, right? So that is the objective of this generation nowadays. They are moving in that direction. Since you can understand that all the other services are conventional, they has not been, we have not introduced any other type of thing in the development of all the generations. We are improving the connectivity, right? You can see we are having a better handoff techniques as compared to the previous. In 2G, 3G, many of the time, you have faced the issue of disconnection, right? And when while you are traveling from one place to another place, so there will be a kind of signal problems. How that problem gets resolved? With the help of soft handoff, and there is a technique which was involved in it, right? We will discuss if that thing is in our syllabus. But yes, it makes some sense. And now please understand, if network is not there, no connectivity is there, that then that device is nothing but just like a brick, piece of brick, right? We don't want that device anymore. So connectivity is the topmost priority when we are talking about connectivity, when we are talking about network connection, right? So in all these generations, what we are dealing with, more and more connectivity, more and more range, right? With high speed, you can see with high data rate and low cost. If cost is high, then people will not able to, you can see, they will not accept that technology. Or you can say that that technology will not become much popular. Right. So that was the thing. Yes. Yes, any doubt, class, you want to ask in this particular? So this is how we can expand our wired network, right? So we know that wired network is a fixed network, and till our home, we are getting that wired network. But if we want to provide a portion of mobility to that devices, then what we can have? We can have Wi-Fi at home, right? Or hotspot internet, right? So now, instead of connecting our devices like laptop and tabs through wire at our home, what we will get using Wi-Fi, what we can get, we get certain level of mobility, right? Up to 200 to 250 meters, not more than that. But yes, the background of this technology is wired only. That's why I have said this thing in beginning, right? So this is a wired which is coming back from the service provider, right? So there is a service provider like Airtel or Jio, right? All the service provider it may be connected with fiber optics also. Now it is turned into fiber optics. So as we know, the bandwidth of fiber optics is much higher as compared to the coaxial cable, which is coming in the previous case, or RJ45 or RJ11, when we are having broadband connections like using modem, we are making use of modem, right? So if you remember, I don't think that you have used that type of devices since this technology come in picture from very early stage. So if I talk about in 90s or 2000, what we have modem, and through modem we are connecting, right? So at our home we have that RJ45, RJ11, that landline, and the same wire is going to connect with a modem, and through that modem then we are connecting with our device. So this is a wired, complete wired connection. You can see there is no mobility at all over here, not a single up. So what is the fun of having a laptop with this wired connection, right? It doesn't make any sense to have a laptop and then make use of. So to replace this thing and to provide certain level of mobility to the end device only, we introduce the concept of Wi-Fi, where a user can get 200 to 250 or 300, depending upon the power transmission of a radio signal. We can get this particular thing, mobility, right? And what we are getting, ultimately, we are getting internet. We are seeking for that only, right? That type of service. So we want that thing to be run in our devices. So that's why we are talking about that thing, that that is internet using Wi-Fi, right? But the background is same, that is wired. Only the end devices such as laptop, tabs, and mobile phone, they could get certain level of mobility. Please try to remember this thing, right? The next in this way category, we'll see that the devices that we have, handheld devices, they are equipped with such type of technology like GPS, global positioning system, for map, for navigation, right? So as we are evolving, things are coming in picture, right? More, and we are depending more and more on the system, right? So users are demanding such type of application. So we are putting that thing into our handheld devices or in our car, right? The stereo that you have, that could be easily equipped with GPRS, and it will basically help you out. But you can see it make use of two technology over here. First one is, it is making using of satellite also, and making use of internet. So that is required to download the maps, right? So internet is required to download the map, and GPS is required to understand the coordinates, right? So for that, you have to understand that how GPS is basically working, and for that you can see three satellites is needed at the same time, and it works on the principle of distance equal to rate into time, right? Where the rate is the speed of light, and it is mentioned as c. So distance d is equal to c into time. So how much time it take to reach from where we can able to calculate the distance, right? So over here you can see that we have time t1, and then we have time t2, right? You can see over here, and this is the propagation time from where it will able to reach to the object, right? Where that device is actually from, which is getting the signal, right? Okay, so that is a short description of this thing. Yet that is not in our syllabus, but yes, please remember the thing that how it is going, right? Next, what we have a one more technology. This is a SMS where we can send some of the text up to this much character, and we can make use of it, and some kind of notification like your ATM notification, withdraw, right, money transfer, all that could be easily get from here. And it is we are using for that purpose only. We are not using, see, after the debut of you can see WhatsApp, now we are not making use of SMS, right, much more of that. Then in this category we have one more, that is near field communication, which make use of radio signals again. And we have a smart card in our hand. We simply tap it on the device, where a device will radiate some signal, right? So we have a device which will activate the card, which is equipped with that information over here, and then it will send that information. So you can say it is very easy for some kind of transactions, right? Then we talked about this thing also, that is wireless sensor network, where this is a network of sensors which are deployed randomly in a network, and we don't have any router in between, dedicated router in between, right? Over here, every device is equally treated, right? No one is superior. And device can communicate through other device or to the to this gateway or sync through this intermediate devices, right? So this device will act as a sender. This device could act as an intermediator or forwarding the packet so that it can able to reach to the nation. And why we are doing this thing? Because we know that they are equipped with less power, right? So if their power is less, you can say that we cannot make use of them for longer transmission, right? For long distance transmission. Why? Because energy for transmission, ETX, is directly proportional to the square of the distance. So higher the distance, higher energy for that transmission is required. This is a universal formula that we are making use when we are talking about this one, right? So please understand. So instead of transmitting directly to this, you can understand that this value will get increased. Automatically, this value get increased. So what will happen? This node will drain out much earlier. So instead of doing that, what we are doing, we are making use of a device which is very near to us. Or other schemes are like making use of clusters, forming clusters, right? And in a cluster, there will be a cluster head, and all will transmit the packet to the cluster head, and then cluster will send it directly to this one. So in a sense, we are trying to minimize this value so that the entire network, or we can say the average distance, will reduce. So average distance is reduced, automatically average energy consumption will also reduced. Please try to understand, right? So the energy consumption will also be less if we perform such type of strategies for our forwarding of packet to the destination, right? And why this thing has happened? Because these devices, they are equipped with less hardware, as it will directly proportional to the cost. So if we, and since we are deploying it in an open field, now if this thing are costly, then may people take away to their home this thing, right? And make use of this thing for the other purpose. So this, they have designed intentionally this thing to be in a manner that if someone will try to capture it or try to destroy it or take away, what will happen? It will not make any sense because it will work in a network only, right? So they are equipped in such a manner. They are designed in such a manner. Right? And other factors are also there because of harsh weather condition. These devices could easily be damaged because of fire in a forest, because of flood and all, right? Sometime accidentally, taking example of habitat monitoring, where animals are equipped with some sensor to understand their movement from one place to another place, we are making use of such type of devices, right? So yes, many applications has been come forward after the introduction, after the debut of this sensor node, right? And not only on a single dimension, you can see it could able to help us in many application, in many sectors, such as medical field. So same sensors, if we equipped with the patient, you can understand that there is no need of doctor 24/7 to engage with the patient, as these sensors are deployed with the deployed in the body of a patient, right? In that manner, we named it body sensor network. Please remember this thing, what is body sensor network, right? So what we do, we place the sensor to observe the heart pulse, body temperature, right? And BP, anything that doctor required, right? For 24/7 monitoring. And with the help of this network now, these values or statistics could easily be available in the device which is available with the doctor. Now the doctor can easily move from one location to another location for some critical cases, other accident cases, or some other reasons. They are not forced to stay at hospital all the time, right? So yes, this technology also help in this manner. Other are also there, right? We make use of that thing. Yes, any doubt you can ask. Yes, just hold on, I have to take a screenshot and I will continue. Meanwhile, if you have any doubt, you can ask me. Yes, anyone? Okay. Coming back to our slide, let me clear the screen and then we'll proceed. So this was there. And these are the multiple applications which you can see over here, right? We are making use them for some kind of nuclear hazards to detect if something catastrophic equation or situation has happened. You can see over here for fire detection, we make use of them. For the health monitoring of the bridges, we can make use of this type of sensor network. For traffic monitoring, for management of traffic, we make use of this type of sensors, right? For home automation, building, and you can see even for office automation, we make use of them. Smart parking is one of that example nowadays. And we even want it for our country, right? You can see that if we could able to have a sensor parking system, then there will be a transparency, there will be a more, you can say, transparent, right, system. Because if you are availing that service, you are paying for it, and it will automatically, the paid amount will automatically go to the government account, right? So we make use of such type of thing. And even this thing will make more convenient to the user, right, point of view. So many, many applications are there. Can say that thousands of applications are there associated with this. And this is one example you can see, which I'm just talking about, that these are the parking marks where we have that magnetic sensor.
And when the iron, big iron body will come over that magnetic sensor, that connection will get established, which will basically activate the camera over there, which will monitor this device 24/7, right? And even that information could easily be availed in the website, which talks about that availability, remaining availability of the parking slots. So isn't you think that this such type of application is needed for our country, where other countries, they are already trying to implement such type of things, right? So if you are interested, then in definitely we will think of it. And I will definitely try to help you out making use of Internet of Things, IoT, and for our institute, if we could able to make such type of application. So I want a few students, if you are interested, you can contact me, right, for this particular. Yes, moving further. Over here, you can see this is a perfect example of home automation, where things are monitored and controlled remotely. Right, you can see the taps could be easily controlled for watering, right, where the switches for AC lights could be easily controlled, even the TV, right, heating system, live recording for your animals, right, over here, and some kind of if there is a some kind of vibrations, right, in the bridges, then you can easily able to understand the conditional, live condition of that. So we could able to, in a sense, what we can able to do, we can able to safeguard the human life, right, with the help of this. And even we can see that we can make use of this sensor where human cannot reach physically. So we can simply throw them out over there, like in volcano eruption. We can send, we can throw them over there, and it will easily notify us within the time period and before such kind of, you can say, disaster, before any disaster could happen. So we can make use of these sensors for safeguard the human life, right? Yes. So some social issues are there also there, right? And some acts are also there that we need to understand, and that is network neutrality, and there is a Digital Millennium Copyright Act, profiling users, and there is a phishing, right, for this. So these are some social issues, right? So it is now time to turn our attention from the application and the social aspect of networking to the technical issues involved in the networking design, right? So what are the technical issues that we will learn in our next class, right? I am left with only 1 minute. So if you have any doubt,